Welcome to Analytics with Nax. In this video, I'm going to talk about DAX Studio, another external tool. What it is, when to use it, once you use it, what are the advantages you're going to get. Let's try to check it out as part of this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. The main purpose of this tool is for debugging. What is I meant is when you have a complicated meshes, then you want to try it out different possibilities, like adding a var condition or filters, or you need to create variables and you need to debug in multiple steps. Then this tool will help you to create or debugging your complex meshes. The next main purpose is to analyze the performance of the model and to reduce the size of the model. So your model is not performing well, so you need to improve the performance by reducing the size of the model. So how this tool will be helpful, I'm going to check it out, explain you in a couple of minutes. And the third most important thing is, like, you can also able to identify the missing keys. What I mean by the missing keys is, like, you have a product item in your fact table which is not available in your product dimension. Then when you drag and drop any column from your product dimension in your filter pane, it will start appearing a blank. This blank is caused due to the missing keys in your product dimension, which is exist in your fact. So this is the things you can able to identify. There are a lot of other purpose for this DAX Studio. I personally use for these three purpose. With this note, let's try to understand it. And I'm not going to focus on anything on the meshes side, because most of the people don't write complex meshes. I'm going to focus on the performance and the missing keys. So I'm in Power BI now. This is the simple model that is created from AdventureWorks database, which contains fact and surrounded by the dimension tables. And you can see how I'm going to this. The disclaimer is, like, this is not a poorly performing model. This is just for your understanding how you can able to analyze your data models if it is really not performing. Okay, so the DAX Studio is your tool to help that. And if you are not installed it, go to Google. You can start typing daxstudio.org, then you can download it, then it will start appearing for you. Then once it start appearing, as soon as you download, it will not appear installing. You need to close the Power BI, all the existing Power BI files, then reopen the Power BI. Then only the DAX Studio will appear after installation. So assuming this AdventureWorks file is not performing, then go to DAX Studio, the external tools. Then go to advanced tab here. And you can see from this view that this is connected to a Tableau model or a Power BI model. And then it will display all the tables present in your model. And this is the important tab that is used for analyzing the performance or list of columns used in this and how much it occupied everything. So just click on advanced and view metrics. It will quickly run through. If it is a very big model, it will take some couple of minutes as well until it analyzes. So from this table, you can see the biggest table in this model is sales order, which is having the cardinality. This is very important, which is nothing but number of rows and how much this table has occupied. Then the dictionary is very important factor over here. So analyzing all these things, you can see this is the biggest table, because obviously it's a fact table, it should have. Then in the table won't acquire much, it is all the about the columns. You can just go through, expand this table, then you can see out of all the tables, This table alone, like sales order alone, occupied 61%. If you focus only on this table and reduce it to 50%, then entire model is compressed. So obviously we need to ask one of the simplest way to improve the performance is to reduce the model size, right? Whichever column is not used, you can get rid of. So from here you can see the sales order line table, sales order line column is not at all used. I hope the order line is nothing but for each row it generates some line number, right? That is not part of any measures or not used anywhere. Then you can get rid of this table. Then you will get your sizes reduced. So this is how you can able to easily go through all the tables and the columns which are not required. You can, if it is really not required, you can get rid of it. But if you have used some calculations out of this table, you cannot able to get rid of that, then you need to pay the price. This is what the point I want to make. So just you can go to the next tab here, that is the columns, where you can see the first tab is all about the tables, and you can expand to the columns. Here it will show each column wise across across the database whichever columns use the most, right? As in we see already seen in the previous sales order table, sales order line is the column that used the most. From this you can get the whichever columns are most used, right? This is the same hierarchical view the table has provided, but only at the column level. So this is how you can able to analyze which column used most, and you can get rid of. The next thing is, like, you can see the summary of these model. Like, this is used only, as I mentioned before, this is for your demonstration. You can see the total size of this model is 15.16, number of columns used. This gives you the overall summary of your tables. Then going back to the third point, missing keys. What I mean by missing keys, this relationship, right? You can see here missing keys. So let me explain what is this all about. Basically, like, this one to many side of your relationship. You can see maximum cardinality, that is, I think the date key 1461 entries are in this date table, which is present in the date table, but in sales order date key only 1081 keys are present. So this is the from cardinality to cardinality. Basically, this will be very useful when you have a very big dimension, say for example 1 million records in your dimension, party dimension or customer dimension, but in your fact table you have only 10,000 rows. There is no point in loading all the 1 million parties when you have only 10,000 records, 10,000 parties entries, right? So in those cases you can able to get rid of this parties 1 million. Instead of 1 million parties, you can load only those parties are used in your fact. So this will be very helpful. How you can see is, like, 1 to M ratio. This is ideally fine. That is 15.24% is fine. But see here 124%, where you can see from this diagram. This is what I meant. This is a good example, where local date, some dimension here, it is 1826 entries, but in your fact or connected table, you have only 48 entries matching for it. So that is 1 to M ratio is 124% mismatch. So this requires intervene, right? So like this, this relations can be identified. So this is one point I mentioned. And also here you can see about the missing keys. This is not a good candidate for missing keys. I have another model. I'm going to sales analysis. Let's open DAX Studio. For this model, I'm going to demonstrate the scenario for the missing keys. That's why I use the another model, because AdventureWorks is properly designed, so you don't find that much missing keys. Let's see this one. So you have a inventory Davis item, which is your fact table, and inventory item is your dimension table. Okay. So in this dimension, what it says is there are total 74 items, out of which 58 is matching in the fact, and in the fact there are 4 items, okay, missing keys, 4 items. Those items are here: green chili sauce, mango, pizza, pasta sauce, okay. And number of rows affected because of this is 6. So this will give you the overall idea of which fact having the missing keys of the dimension. Assume the product dimension, in this case it's inventory, assume this is a product. Product is connected to different fact tables, not all the fact table having violation, only this fact has a violation, right? So it will be very difficult without this tool, what relationship caused the violation. So now you identified it here, there are 4 items in this fact table, you have the missing keys, then you go and add those items either in this table or get rid of some calculations, I mean get rid of that fact if it is really invalid, right? So this is what the DAX Studio is all about. You can check the overall size of it, then get rid of the unused columns, then you can use the missing keys analysis. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.